there.
You like them?
Yes, I like them.
How long have you had them?
He don't talk back. He don't bite. He don't eat a lot.
How long have you had him?
Huh?
How long have you had him?
Couple days.
Couple days?
Yeah.
Made a big difference for you?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I talk to him all the time, whether he talks back or not. It doesn't matter. I talk to him.
Gives you a lot of friends.
See, his tail's wagging. See? You going to talk again now, huh? You want to talk to him again, huh?
I'm Becky Preve. I'm director at Franklin County Office for the Aging. New York State Office for the Aging approached all 59 area agencies on aging with a pilot project to combat social isolation and loneliness. Currently, those two items are truly a public health emergency, and we look at targeting different projects that potentially can assist with alleviating those issues. So essentially what has happened is 15 counties in New York State have piloted an anisotropic pet pilot project, which is what Rita actually has. And these are animals that interact. They respond to being pet or someone talking with them. And they are very realistic and lifelike. And what locally Franklin County Office for the Aging did was reach out to the Community Friendship Volunteer Program as we work in partnership and referrals across the spectrum. And we were able to identify a patient of the Community Health Center who's also involved with the Community Friendship Volunteer Program and is also served through Office for the Aging locally. And we were able to pair Rita with her new animal who has absolutely brought joy and comfort to her. What we do with the program, because we are looking at data, is we actually measure how isolated and lonely someone is feeling when we adopt the pet, and then we follow up in 3 months, 6 months, and 1 year. And the intent is that this project is very inexpensive, but has a far-reaching value that can really assist across the spectrum. So what we look at is that these pets may reduce trips to the emergency department. They may provide engagement. As you can see with Rita, she interacts with her pet, and since he has been adopted, she has indicated that he brings her much joy. So globally, it's definitely a partnership, not only from a primary care perspective, but also joining programs that really interlap and cross with one another. And we're very thankful that the Community Friendship Volunteer Program was able to identify Rita as someone that would benefit from this project. So from a perspective globally of what projects like this are able to do, and programs like the Community Friendship Volunteer and programs through local offices for the aging, they are low cost, they are predicated on non-Medicaid eligible individuals, and simple projects that are able to impact loneliness and isolation are able to alleviate a much higher cost to the healthcare system. People that are engaged in programs and services like Community Friendship Volunteer or with local offices for the aging are actually able to age in place, and they're able to remain in their own homes with autonomy. So from our perspective in the Aging Network, we're really looking at innovative pilot programs that, again, really impact people globally and also touch on the healthcare system. So we were very fortunate in Franklin County. We were able to adopt 6 pets. And again, they were provided by New York State Office for the Aging. The intent is when we show metrics of this program really impacting, that this will become a statewide project. I would personally like to really highlight the fact that programs and services offered through local offices for the aging encompass really a holistic approach. And I think that this project really shows a federally qualified healthcare center, a friendship volunteer program, and an office for the aging coming together for the right thing for not only the patient, but also the community.